we've got a lot to celebrate in the studio tonight because McFly are having a 21st birthday. There they are! And everyone is invited. They're in the building, as you heard, and ready to tell us when and where we need to be.
Yeah, I mean, I can't believe they're turning 21.
I know.
I mean, they look so...
Wow. That's a picture.
Yeah. Someone else we know who is set to host a massive party this weekend with myself, actually, is Clara Amfort. We're talking the Brits, and Clara's here to tell us who's joining us on the guest list.
Exciting stuff. Also tonight, there's going to be a celebration in Albert Square on Monday when the iconic Bianca Jackson makes a return to EastEnders. Now, she'll be telling superfan Gabby Roslin all about it a bit later.
Yeah, and it's not long. Time to introduce our first guest for this evening. You might have heard them giggling from earlier on. They're a chart-topping group who are celebrating 21 years of bringing us just mega hits like this. And it turns out they want everyone to celebrate with them. And by the number of emails and messages that we've had, it's going to be a good one. Please welcome McFly!
See, I mean, we should say, first of all, congratulations on hitting 21.
Yeah, thank you.
I can't even believe that.
Makes
that
you feel old, doesn't it?
It's like you must have started when you were two, then.
Pretty much, don't you? Yeah. What were you?
I was 15.
15. Yeah. Gosh, were you?
Yeah.
Wow, that is small.
You thought that was a joke?
Yeah, I did. Tom, when you started, how long did you envisage this was going to go on for?
Well, I think the truth is we all wanted... We were in it for the long run from the beginning.
I was in it for the money.
Were you, right? All of us are married. And I think we always were committed to this being, you know, the four of us for as long as people wanted us to be around together. It just, we're very lucky that people still want us to be around after 21
years. It's a huge compliment, isn't it?
Well, I do have to say, Harry, your parents wanted you to get a proper job, as they would say. Is that right?
Yeah, they sat me down when these guys were in the band first and they chose me and Doug to be in the band with them. And my parents tried to say, no, you're not going to be in the band. You know, you've gone to school, we want you to go to uni and get a proper job. And I was like, and I said to them, I said, if you stop me from being spent, I will never forgive you. And I remember they looked at each other and smiled and they're like, OK, fine. But I mean, what would I have done?
Well, are they satisfied now?
they're happy with the decision. But I mean, I don't know what any of us would have done if it wasn't, if we weren't at McFly. I mean, literally.
Speak for yourself, mate. I would have soared.
Yeah. You probably would, mate.
I tell you what, we have had, haven't we, so many emails and questions for you. We decided... Let the viewers do our job tonight.
Nice.
So we're
just
going to read out questions and then you can answer, all right? So here we go. Justine asks Danny, will your birthday be a lot of your old songs and do we all have to wear party hats?
Literally, bring your best party attire. It's going to be a huge ball pit.
Is it?
It's going to be a huge ball pit.
Like that?
You can bring balloons. But yeah, it'll be all the hits. And maybe some other surprises that we've got planned. Maybe Piranha might turn out.
We'll get to that later. We will get to that. Because, I mean, look, you guys have so many different generations in terms of, like, you know, young and old that are just still loving your music. I mean, here is a wonderful question from the younger generation, Hugo.
Hi, McFly. I'm Hugo, and I'm a huge McFly fan, as you can see. Dougie has inspired me to learn bass. And I now have my own band with my friends, and we are called Power to Play after your album, which is my favourite. We have a show coming up, and I'm feeling very nervous. Have you got any advice on coming over stage fright? I can't wait to see you perform next time. Bye!
Firstly, Dougie, you did it. You inspired a bass player.
I finally did it. And I feel guilty now. I feel like I should point him in the direction of people that can actually play.
But you asked a great question. How do you get over stage fright? I mean, who wants to take it?
This is worse, you know?
Live TV.
Way worse.
Performing, like, performing on live TV is more nerve-wracking. I mean, it never really leaves you, does it?
I think there's a fine line between nerves and excitement. If you can turn it into excitement and learn that nerves are always going to be there, nerves mean that you care, but turn it into excitement and just go for it and give it your all.
I always make like a loud noise or do something stupid right at the top of the show and that makes me you know, that's as bad as it's going to get.
Nice. So Hugo is very young.
Yes, but we've got Ellie here who's saying, out of all of your songs, what would your debut single be?
Ooh. What, if we could go back?
Yeah, if you could go back to the beginning.
Yeah.
I wouldn't change it.
Something that we've got writing credits on.
Yeah, so, something that I wrote on.
No, I wouldn't change it. We'll I would keep it the way it is.
Not change a thing. Five colours.
I see.
Okay, good. Now then, you two, bit of news. You're going to be sharing a button on The Voice. So, Dan, you've let Tom get in on the act.
He wasn't quite good enough. They needed Tom wanted me and Dougie originally, but they couldn't afford us.
So you went for you. But we were a bit worried that you're going to slam each other's hands trying to get to the button. Have you talked about it? Button technique.
We've got a little bit of a kind of strategy, but I think it's trust in your bandmate. So if you want to go, I trust you. And if I want to go, you trusted me.
We kind of have to talk through our eyes. Yeah. Whether we're going to go or not.
Yeah. Did, yeah.
I mean, there's one time I just grabbed Tom's hand and hit the button.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I was unsure. He just took the hand and did it for me.
Like he's a puppet.
And then there's one I didn't want to turn for and he did. So it was one of those. We had fun, though. So much fun.
It looks
like it was one of the funniest times we've had.
Look at that. The double seat.
It's big. The chair's big.
Love seat. Yeah. You can see McFly at London's O2 on the 9th and 10th of October. Yeah. Indeed. And we've got more must-see TV now because tomorrow night, one of the world's most prestigious music events is taking place. We're talking the Brits, of course. Now, Roman will be there with Maya Jama and the one and only Clara Amfer, who's also here with us now. Hi,
Clara. Hello, everyone.
I mean, I feel like a proud mother. I'm so excited for you.
Brilliant. Roman, it's been a whole, 2 hours since we've seen each other?
Yeah, I know, exactly. I know. It's been so long.
It's been so long.
Yeah, you've both been hard rehearsing this week. It's been a lot, hasn't it? It's all ready for tomorrow. Who are you looking forward to seeing perform, Clara?
Oh, we're really sport this year, aren't we? Mm. I mean, obviously Kylie, because she is our global icon. Obviously.
Queen.
Obviously. I've got so many in the back pocket, you have no idea. I think Ray's going to be amazing. We've got Rema, Chasing Status, Becky Hill. I mean, the list goes on, but we're really sport this year, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, Dua Lipa as well. It'll just be like, you know.
She's
it'll
amazing.
Be unbelievable.
Bit controversial last year, wasn't it? Because all those people nominated for Best Artist were male. Mm-hmm. So how are we looking this year?
Oh, it's quite the opposite, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean,
it's... The force is female.
Well, also, I think as well, like, you know, when you look at the nominations and who's there, it's like, who's got the best body of work out there as well? And currently, the girls are just absolutely smashing it. Mm. So, rightly so, you know, people like Ray, people like Tate McRae's as well, and Dua Lipa, as you mentioned. Mm. Of course, they've got to be in there.
Yeah, but Ray is... She's tipped to take home a fair few awards, isn't she?
Nominated 7 times.
Wow.
So she's already won one. She already won the Songwriter
Award. She can just give some away if she gets all 7. And there's a brand new category as well this year, isn't there?
Mm, there is. So Ray has won the Songwriter Award. That's been announced publicly.
Right, yeah.
And I think that's an award that, you know, she's really proud to get because, you know, as we know, like, she's been through a lot, like, sort of publicly and, like, you know, her songs are her baby. So it's great that she's getting that award.
Yeah. Mm.
When we were looking through some Brits archive footage, this one.
It's amazing.
For the best half of McFly Award.
Yeah, Clara and I got asked to invite our favourites. Yeah. And they weren't available. So we went with the two. But, I mean, who would you hope to see win kind of this year?
We were saying Noah Kahan.
Yes.
He's amazing. Olivia Dean.
Oh,
I think
she's
got an amazing
lovely voice.
Yeah. When she sings, it's so beautiful. And Pink Panthers.
Oh,
who sampled or did something with our lyrics in the song.
One of our songs,
which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
What I find mad as well, right, is we're talking about all these new artists as well, but did you know today, as in on the charts, we've actually got Jules Holland first number one record, number one album for Jules Holland.
Wow. Congratulations, Jules. Yeah. You can watch The Brits tomorrow night, 8:30, live on ITV1 and ITVX. Good luck, both.
Thank you. We carry on our evening of celebrations with a trip down to Albert Square now because there's just 72 hours to go until one of EastEnders' most iconic characters returns to our screens. And yes, Pam St. Clements may have been spotted behind a bar this week, but it's not her. Stop. Here's superfan Gabby Roslin meeting an icon of the East End.
She's sharp-tongued.
Oh, shut up!
She's famous for yelling. And after a five-year hiatus...
Ouch! What are you doing?
I should have done it in the first place!
She's back. Patsy Palmer is returning to EastEnders as Bianca Jackson. And as a massive fan, I cannot wait. So I've come to meet her right here at the Queen Vic.
What a surprise! Bianca is back!
Here we are on the square.
I know, and I haven't been on. This is a newly kind of designed, built lot, even though it's the same, but first time I've been on here as well.
Well, welcome back. I would like to take you back to the very beginning.
Bianca first arrived on the square over 30 years ago in 1993.
Haven't you got a brain, eh? Hey, don't walk away from me while I'm talking to you!
You're not talking to me, you're shouting at me!
When you first came into EastEnders and you became such a massive character, do you remember?
I remember coming onto this lot, not this lot, the other one, and just feeling so surreal because there was like Pete Beale and Doc Cotton, and I just remember feeling in awe of everybody, like, wow.
Some of the really big storylines that I remember, obviously in there, giving birth.
Oh, yeah, giving birth, and I had the Mitchell brothers
as the midwives. Mitchell.
Brilliant. I'm ringing an ambulance. You won't go with me. We'll get an ambulance, take you to hospital, yeah?
Oh, I told you! Where's Ricky?
They're just brilliant. It's like soap at its best. Can I help you,
Nick? Bianca has had her fair share of dramatic storylines, most famously her relationship with Ricky Butcher, played by Sid Owen.
A relationship that will always go down in soap history, you and Ricky.
Yes, yeah. And Sid and I, you know, we have a chemistry. We've been friends since we were kids anyway, because we went to drama school together. So we already had a friendship before I came onto EastEnders, and I think that's why they put us together, because our chemistry is brilliant.
Bianca's other major friendship is with Kat Slater, played by Jessie Wallace.
I can't fight you in your condition. If you like wrestling a Teletubby, you'd fall on me, I'd probably suffocate. You've got some gob on you, haven't you? Pop, kettle.
I've loved the stuff that I did with Kat. They write really well for those two. I think Bianca and Kat were a brilliant partnership as friends.
After first stepping onto the square as a fresh-faced 21-year-old, Patsy has made several returns for the show. But now, 5 years on from her last appearance, I want to know if anything's changed.
You know, everybody always says when you go away and you come back and then the minute you're there again, it doesn't feel like you've ever been away.
No, never. Here, nothing has changed. It's the only place in the world that is, that you could have that feeling.
In Bianca's upcoming storyline, she isn't even living in the square. She settled in Milton Keynes until her stepdaughter, Whitney, comes to visit following Bianca's breakup with her latest love interest, Terry Spraggan.
What are you most nervous about?
It always feels new, because you always want to go back with a fresh head. So you never really want to go back with the same head. I'm not here with the same mindset that I was when I left. So it's a fresh experience, but exactly the same place.
So off she goes then. Bianca and Whitney reunited. As a super fan, I cannot wait to see this. Oh, I'm counting the days.
Oh, it's going to be fantastic, isn't it?
It is. Oh, classic-y.
Oh, Bianca back on Monday night at 7:30.
Yes. Now then, Tom.
Yes.
We have to talk about Paddington. Don't look worried. Because you have been set a special mission. Would you like to share with the group?
Yes, I'm writing the music for Paddington the Musical.
Oh, wow. Wow. Yeah. Wow. That is
awesome. Incredible. Yes.
You haven't heard any of it yet.
No, but when can we hear it?
I don't know how much I'm allowed to say. I'm hopefully next year, if everything goes to plan, if I actually write the rest of the songs that I need to write for it.
Oh, man, that is going to be so good.
It is amazing. It's one of those projects that as soon as you say that to someone, Paddington, everybody loves Paddington, and it just seems to make sense as a musical.
Yeah.
And it's a really special project to be part of. I feel so lucky. The whole team is amazing and everyone is in for such a treat when they see
it.
It's quite the pressure, isn't it?
Well, I mean...
Paddington.
Speaking of pressure...
yeah.
Danny, now we can come to it. You were the winner of The Masked Singer.
Yeah.
Oh, wow! Yeah. How did it go down at home?
Well, basically, I've been lying to my son for about 4 months.
Yes,
and he'll never believe a word we say ever again.
But this is the moment he found out, and this is so lovely.
Yeah.
I love
this.
That is such a lovely moment.
Oh, that is the best, isn't it?
Yeah.
So cute.
It's funny, I put up a video today of the week leading up to it and him going, every time we watched it, every Saturday night, it was like, Daddy, it's got to be you. That's your voice. Another clip next week. It's got to be you. Is it you? I said, no, mate, I'm here. How can I be in the TV?
Oh, well, it's smoking mirrors.
You won at the end.
But I would have missed that. If it wasn't for my wife, I'd have missed that because she set up the camera. And she was filming us, and it was all natural. It was amazing. What an amazing moment. I'd have completely missed that.
Oh, it's worth it, though, for that.
Yeah, thanks so much to all of our guests for joining us.
Good luck, you two, for tomorrow night. We'll all be watching, and we'll see you after the weekend. Bye-bye.